I urge that. What's the very first thing he encourages us to do? To pray. Prayer is not God. This is who I think should win. Make it so. That's not prayer. That's politicking heaven. This is prayer. God, I'm leaving my politics right there, and I am turning. And I am submitting myself to the King of the universe. Have your way in me. That's prayer. Prayer is encounter with God and allowing that which is in heaven to impact you which is on earth. And then we in turn turn and pour out that which is in heaven into the earth. It is not our job to storm heaven with what we think should happen in the earth. It is our job to find out what is that purpose, what is that will, what is that heart that will flood the earth with abundant life. And then we turn and pour it out. Hey, wouldn't that be great if the person you didn't think should win won, and the first thing you did when you prayed is you said, "Thank you, Jesus." You would really find out where your heart is if you could genuinely say, "Thank you, Jesus." Because the one who will always be on the throne is still there. That's how we pray. For there is one God and one mediator also between God and men. What Paul is doing here is he's reminding Timothy, it does not matter who's in authority, there's still only one God, and there's still only one person that will end up deciding the end game, the judgment, the fate of mankind. Not a ruler, not an authority, and not an election. Someone in office will not ever have the final word about men and women and children. God alone does. Jesus should get our primary focus, even when we're walking in on Tuesday and I don't know, I think we're coloring circles. I think we decided that, right? We're coloring circles in Pennsylvania. Okay, as we're walking in, my heart is declaring Jesus is Lord of the United States, and as a result, I'm voting. Do it. Don't be thinking about your political agenda. Don't be thinking about anything else, but Jesus is Lord, and you're praying for the person you're coloring in. And you pray for the person you didn't color in. That's when you know Jesus is Lord in your life. Look, like, it actually helps us to sleep well at night to speak well of those in authority, to think well of those in authority, to pray for those in authority. I know it sounds like, come on, Mark, it's not that simple. I actually think it is. It's the same premise that we're encouraged multiple times in Scripture to honor our father and mother. It doesn't matter how bad a parent they were. It doesn't matter if they hurt you, spoke evil of you, or loved you like God himself. When you honor them, the promise is it will go well with you. What does remain is, Jesus, I honor you. And I bring this person who's in this seat, and I bring them to you. And I say, Lord, would you have your way in them? Guide their heart, guide their mind, touch their spirit, that they might think and make decisions as if you would.